Good morning. The Hamilton County Grand Jury has indicted this morning Satwinder Singh for the death of Damian Turner Jr. This is a most tragic situation. It truly feeds into the fact that we have a serious problem with opiates, and this little boy tragically died because of this. The recklessness of this defendant is beyond belief. The father described to our prosecutors that he literally could see his son's brain because he was hit so hard in his stroller. And I don't know if you're familiar with Hopple Street, but that curb is up probably 2.5 to 3 feet high. It's really very tall. And he, because of his addiction or whatever, passed out and then climbed the curb and struck the stroller. He's facing 14 years in prison. And believe me, if we could have figured out a way to get more out of it, we would have. But I think it was, Julie's 8 days before.
Yes.
8 days before, he was in Kentucky. He was told not to drive, no drugs, no alcohol, nothing. And obviously he didn't comply with that. The reason I asked the chief to be here today is because the diligence and I've traveled this country and observed law enforcement across the board. The people of Cincinnati don't realize how good the police are here in Cincinnati. They are the best I've ever seen. And a lot of credit goes to this chief. And I've seen other communities around Ohio, around the country, and there's nothing like it. And what their work in this case did and how they apprehended him, how they dealt with the drugs involved in this, the chief should be very proud of what they've done. The problem, though, is that we lost little Damian. He's a beautiful little boy, and it was a damn shame that this happened. So we're going to seek justice for him. We're going to do our best. We're going to contact Kentucky, see if they can add on some things, because he clearly violated the order of the court in Kentucky. And hopefully this guy goes away for a long time. Chief, you want to say something?
Sure.
Thank you, Joe. First, let me just express my condolences to the Turner family. This is a tragedy that should not have occurred. Mr. Singh's action demonstrated a very clear disregard for all of our laws and the safety of everyone on or nearby a public roadway. This tragic accident is a reminder that it's everyone's responsibility not to drive impaired, and how a life can be taken in an instant by a choice to get behind the wheel of a vehicle without regard for anyone that might come in their path. We all need to take a deep look at this tragedy and see how we can honor young Damian's life. We need to commit to never drive impaired. Continue to take steps that if there's someone that you know of that has an addiction, that we assist those in need. We also need to remove the opportunity for those individuals to drive impaired by working through actions from the court or from families and friends by not allowing anyone you know to drive impaired. I want to thank the Hamilton County Prosecutor Joe Dieters and his team for their assistance and guidance in this investigation. It's always tough when you see such a young, precious life taken. I want to thank the District 5 officers and our traffic unit who worked tirelessly to investigate this tragedy and bring Mr. Singh to justice as quickly as possible. I want to again extend my condolences to the Turner family for the loss of Damian Jr. and to let them know that we are here for them and they continue to be in our thoughts and prayers. Thanks, John.
Any questions?
Chief, Jeff said you guys had to, go through to apprehend this person. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
You know, he didn't immediately stay at the scene. So there was some investigative
Which
work involved.
Which led to the other charges.
Correct.
Yeah. He initially said that he was going to follow them to the hospital, go to the hospital with them, and he just took off. And he went to a BP station down in, I guess,
living in Camp Washington.
Camp Washington, yeah.
After
where he says he owns this place. And he was passed out there. They had to use Narcan on him to revive him. So,
can you talk to us a little bit about the bond, where it stands now? Do you think he's going to get out? Is there a question about that?
He's not going to get out. There's no way.
Certainly doesn't deserve to be out.
Can anyone speak to why there wasn't a higher bond in Kentucky, why there wasn't custody in Kentucky, or return is not as...
My understanding is it was just an OVI, you know, it was not a... Julie, do you know the answer to that?
I'm not sure. I mean, I know his license was suspended, he was told not to consume alcohol or drugs, but I mean, I don't know if Kentucky law or if we have more facts on that.
We're contacting Kentucky today. Mr. Prem's in charge. But I will say this, and the chief touched on it. I cannot imagine losing your 2-year-old child in a situation like this. It is the most horrible thing I could imagine. And in light of the fact that he was under suspension, told not to drive, told not to do drugs, alcohol, and he continued to do it, is reprehensible. And trust me, these prosecutors back here that are on this case, Matt Brew and Dave Prem, they've looked long and hard at trying to put this guy away forever. And we just don't have the charges to do that. So hopefully Kentucky can add on, and we'll see what happens after that. Thank you, everybody.
Thanks,
Chief.
Thanks, sir.
One more question. Sure.